Hey everybody, Homeslice Henry here, and in today's video, we're taking a look at an unexpected pick that I had a ton of success with in the Open Great League, Escavalier. Escavalier, not only does it do very well against the new meta edition of Clodsire, but it also does great into some meta staples like Superior, Charm Alolan Ninetales, and Alolan Sandslash. I paired it up with a Sableye Safe Switch and a Cresselia as the closer, and was able to string together quite a few 4-1 sets. So without further ado, let's hop into the matches, and let's check out Great League Escavalier dominating the competition in the Open Great League. Hopping into the first match, and we see the Dream lead leading Escavalier into Alolan Sandslash. Opponent safe switches into Medicham, and I get to immediately respond with Sableye. Sableye, of course, has a dominating matchup here. Escavalier can do very well in an anti-meta role, but one thing that it really struggles against is going to be going up against Medicham. So that's why in the back, we have two very strong counters to Medicham with the Sableye and the Cresselia. I make sure to go for the foul play before they connect with the second Ice Punch, as now I can farm down and lead with energy to threaten the Sandslash. One foul play, of course, will not KO, but it will do a solid amount of damage to my opponent. Foul play into the A-Slash is shielded, which is a bit of a surprise. They get some energy, but I can send in a Escavalier in the back. It's Pelipper, and Cresselia up a shield very comfortably takes this win, and the opponent concedes the match. Moving into the next match, leading Escavalier into Shadow Charm Alolan Ninetales, and Escavalier is able to win all even shielding scenarios. Here, my opponent throws on alignment, so unfortunately, I will actually have to shield first in this matchup. I was just looking to overfarm as much as I possibly could. I farm up past the double drill run, and at this point, my opponent knows they're losing Switch, so they're just gonna let the Ninetales go. In comes Medicham, and I decide actually to stay in here. I go for the Mega Horn, but I don't pivot for a very important reason. And that's the fact that a lot of the times, if it's Charm Alolan Ninetales and a Medicham, there is a Carbink in the back. So pivoting Sableye could be a lose con. So I send in the Sableye, but it's not switch locked. So when they bring in the Carbink, I can send in Cresselia. The team read proves to be a solid one. And now I'm in the driver's seat of this match. Cresselia, due to its immense bulk, able to withstand the fast move pressure and the Moonblast from the Carbink, no problem. And Cresselia will just continue to chip away Grass Knot after Grass Knot into the Carbink. Grass Knot is going to connect. Carbink now going to get KO'd by the next charge move here. They have to shield or they do not have a win con. Opponent chooses to no shield, and there's just nothing Medicham can do versus this backline, and the opponent concedes the match. We see a very unusual pick in the next match, Escavalier into Shadow Hypno. I have not seen a Shadow Hypno in many seasons, so I was a bit surprised to see it. I save switch into the Sableye, and my opponent sends in Umbreon. This Umbreon is actually running Dark Pulse. Dark Pulse does shore up the Sableye matchup for Umbreon quite a bit, as Umbreon with the Snarls can cleanly two-shot with Dark Pulse, whereas with Foul Play, if you have a good ranked Sableye, the opponent typically has to throw three moves. So they're going to be firing off the Dark Pulse that is going to connect, and now I'm going to send in Escavalier. And I'm just looking to go for a potential one shield farm down and leave with an overwhelming amount of energy to threaten that Hypno. Because of course, Escavalier has access to Mega Horn, which is an extremely powerful bug type move. In comes the Hypno, and I'm baiting with the drill run here, putting pressure onto the Hypno. Hypno commits the shield. I continue to farm with the Escavalier. Bait so nice, I'm doing it twice. Let's see this. Drill run bait gets the shield. Opponent throwing their energy, and they are one off the back-to-back here. Hypno goes for the Thunder Punch. Escavalier is going to win CMP. This is going to be one-shotting the Shadow Hypno. What do they have in the back? It's Greninja, and this game is over. I can farm up, switch into the Cresselia, and Cresselia very comfortably wins the zeros versus Greninja. Greninja able to land the Night Slash. They're going for Night Slash number two, but it's not going to matter. The backline of this team with the Cresselia able to withstand that charge move pressure, make it to the Grass Knot, and secure the KO onto the Greninja. Moving to the next match, leading Escavalier into another Shadow Alolan Ninetales. This Ninetales, however, is running Powder Snow, but much like the last one, they are staying in what is a profoundly negative matchup, so it looks like, yet again, Escavalier doing some nice core breaking here. I'm farming up with the Escavalier, and I'm going to be firing off this Drill Run before they're able to make it to their next Weather Ball. Drill Run will grab the shield, Ninetales continues to farm, and they play to a CMP tie that they do not win. Opponent going to be forced to give up the final shield. They're now down both of their shields, but I will start shielding back. The fact that they're staying in here shows that Escavalier has some pretty nice value into their team. So I'm more than happy to double shield, counter down, and lead with energy to threaten whatever my opponent decides to send in. Down goes the Ninetales, in comes Medicham, and again, I'm not going to be pivoting out of this in case they have a Carbink in the back. I'm just going to go for the Megahorn, that does massive damage, and then I can send in the Sableye. They can go for the Ice Punch, and then they're going to be switching out, because otherwise they're just getting farmed down. In the back, it's actually a Trevenant, so not a Carbink in the back. I'm a little bit surprised that the opponent stayed in that negative of a lead then, because they did have two Pokemon in the back that could do very well against it, but I can just send in the Cresselia, the Medicham is absolutely helpless, and they resign the match. We see a bit of a tricky lead in the next match, Escavalier into Sableye. I learned after this match, if I lead into a Sableye, I just need to save switch into my own. A lot of the time, opponents will stay in, and it can work out pretty well for you, whereas here, I can win the zero shield as the Escavalier, but if the opponent shields, then unfortunately, I've now put myself in a position where my only steel counter on the team is extremely low. And that's going to be a problem if they have a steel type in the back, and Sableye oftentimes paired with steels. I go for the foul play, they catch onto a Bastiodon, and as you can see, by not protecting the Escavalier, I have lost the game. Bastiodon will be able to sweep me, so I resign the match. Moving into the next set, and we see an amazing lead, Escavalier into Serperior. Opponent save switches into Pelipper, and I'm going to respond with Cresselia. Cresselia does have a nice amount of bulk, being able to withstand a Hurricane. However, shielding a Hurricane does put me in a pretty nice position, so I will still commit the shield, as because Cress is so bulky, it felt unlikely that the opponent would bait there. I go for the Grass Knot, I'm able to grab a shield from my opponent, I continue to farm as the Cresselia, and this is a bit unfortunate, as I accidentally play to a CMP tie, and here I definitely should have gone for the Moonblast. Moonblast does more damage, and if I land a Moonblast, I can potentially look at farming down, whereas here, there's no shot I'm going to be able to farm down, and I'm forced to go for another Grass Knot. So inefficient use of energy here by me, but the opponent is just choosing to let that through and send back in the Serperior. So they do not have switch advantage, but instead they're hoping that with a shield advantage, their final Pokemon will be able to sweep. I'm farming up a ton of energy with the Cresselia, making it to the Moonblast, but very nice counting by my opponent. They will fire off the Frenzy from the Serperior to neutralize Cresselia's energy. In comes the Escav. In the back, we've got some spice from the opponent. Oh my goodness, it's a Great League Lugia. What a flex. Oh my goodness. Unfortunate news for the opponent is they're not going to make the Aeroblast. This is only 8 Dragon Tails, they're one short here, this is just a Sky Attack. Sableye will be able to withstand that damage plus the Dragon Tail and make it to the foul play. Big props to the opponent, they're running some pretty cool spice. Not every day you see a battle that includes a Great League Lugia and a Great League Escavalier. They go for the Aerial Ace, but that's just not going to be enough damage, and the opponent concedes the match. Moving to the next match, hitting Escavalier into Shadow Venusaur. Escavalier again doing core breaking, and the Venusaur is staying in this matchup. Oh my goodness. I go for the Drill Run here. Drill Run does not KO, but it puts them into farm down range. Drill Run connects. Opponent gonna save the energy. They save switch into a Kovagrigus. So a pretty cool team from the opponent. I'm going to be shielding up here, a Shadow Ball would do a ton of damage, and then I can pretty safely double up on moves from the Sableye. I'm expecting my opponent to send back in the Venusaur. Venusaur can typically win CMP over Sableye, so if they do, I'm not going to throw my foul play, I'm just going to go for the one shield farm down. But instead, they send in Dewgong, and up this much energy, Sableye is going to be very uncomfortable for my opponent. I land the first foul play, I make it to foul play number 2, opponent still holding onto those 2 shields, when do they use them? They finally start using the shields now. I continue to farm up with the Sableye, opponent forced to go for the Icy Wind to secure the KO. But now I'm in a very comfortable position. I can send the Cresselia into the Dewgong, and I just save the shield. I know at some point they're going to try and go for a combo play onto the Venusaur, and when they do, I can just shield, because that's going to be the move that does the most damage out of anything here. So I can go for the Grass Knot into the Dewgong, and at this point, the opponent realizes that it's over. They no shield, in comes the Escavalier, and this team just keeps getting top lefts. We see a slightly negative lead in the next match, Escavalier versus Defense Deoxys. I'm going to farm up to the Megahorn and look for a catch onto the Sableye. Unfortunately, my opponent shows great patience holding onto their energy, and now they send in Umbreon. On the bright side, I did need to bait out the Umbreon, but this is a bit unfortunate for me, as now my opponent has a ton of energy loaded on that Deoxys. Umbreon is going to be firing off a charge move, and they're running foul play. 2 foul plays do not KO. They did get a small amount of chip, they got a couple counters, onto the Sableye, which means that they may be able to snarl down after the second foul play connects, but I will be able to make it to this next return. And this will come very close to KOing here. Let's see, is Sableye going to be able to flip it? Getting them low, but the Umbreon lives with a fraction of HP. I send in the Escavalier, and Escavalier is just gonna have to eat the foul play. Foul play gets the Escav low. If they send in the Deoxys, which they do, I'm going for the Mega Horn. Let's see, are they willing to call a bait? It's highly unlikely. Opponent commits the shield. In comes Cresselia. They're firing off energy, and I just have to trust in Cresselia's ability to close in the endgame. But it's not to be. In the back, it's a Shadow Alolan Sandslash. So the opponent was double weak to my Escav in the back, but unfortunately, Escav not able to get the right alignment. But it does get the alignment it's looking for in the next match, leading into an Umbreon. Opponent save switches into a Togetic. Oh my goodness, we've got some spice from these opponents. Let's go. All right, Togetic, obviously an absolute wall to the Escav, so I have to get out of there. Honestly, I wasn't 100% sure what to switch into because I haven't really seen a Togetic at all this season. I do think Togetic is a bit underrated, but it is a bit limited in terms of the fact that it just doesn't have any coverage going up against steel types. So I send in the Cresselia, and just due to Cresselia's bulk, Cresselia is doing pretty well here. This Togetic is running Aerial Ace, which makes it a lot spammier, but without the closing power of Dazzling Gleam, it just can't really compete with the Cresselia. Moonblast is going to secure the KO. In comes the Umbreon, and Umbreon will be hit with a Moonblast. This is super effective damage onto the Umbreon. Umbreon is going to no shield. I continue to farm in the back. It's a Shadow Haunter. Look at the spice from the opponent. But unfortunately, they just have really rough alignment. We see a familiar lead in the next match, Escavalier into Sableye. I'm going to save switch into my own Sableye, learning from my mistakes from that previous loss, and my opponent actually stays in and lets me throw my move first. To me, that's a misplay. If they throw the foul play as soon as they get it, because my switch takes one turn, then they will always be one Shadow Claw ahead of me. But by not doing so, I'm now in a better position. Claude comes in, they go for the Earthquake, and I will commit a shield. I go for the foul play into the Claude. I'm farming up energy. Sableye making it to the return. Claude is very bulky, but return hits very hard from the Sableye. Return is going to connect and secure the KO. In comes Azumarill. I'm looking to farm up energy, and I go for the return. It is on alignment, but I was honestly expecting my opponent to potentially CMP there. I'm now going to pivot into the Escavalier. Escavalier, unfortunately, not the strongest into my opponent's team now that the Clodsire is out of the way, but this Azu is not running Hydro Pump. They throw a Play Rough. They send in the Sableye. Foul play will connect. Escav dies with the move, but I still have my Sableye. These Shadow Claws are adding up. They're extremely low. I send in Cresselia. I'm going to be shielding the super effective foul play and looking for the Psycho Cut farm down, because once I get this farm down, Azu has a shield to hide behind, but Cresselia is just much too bulky in the back. Opponent goes for the Play Rough, and that's not going to be a problem whatsoever for this Cresselia. Cresselia firing off the Grass Knot that will be shielded up by the Azumarill, but Cresselia just way too thick and way too spammy for this Azu to deal with. Grass Knot connects onto the Azumarill, and yet again, we see another opponent concede the match. Hopping into the final match, and I lead Escavalier into Sableye one final time. I save switch into Sableye, my opponent stays in and goes for their foul play as soon as they get it. I'm forced to burn a shield, in comes Shadow Venusaur, and when I see this Venusaur, I see an opportunity. I'm going to full send the return here to guarantee immediate switch advantage or shield advantage. My opponent is going to farm up and fire off a Frenzy Plant, but in this moment, I am prepared to fully counter down with Escavalier. Energy on Escavalier is absurdly strong into this current Great League meta. Frenzy Plant is, of course, going to be double resisted, but Escavalier, despite the double resistance, is not the tankiest. So my play here is I'm going to try and go for a sweep with Escavalier. So I am going to be shielding a double resisted Frenzy Plant, looking for the full counter down, and I leave with a massive amount of energy. Opponent now in an awkward spot. What are they going to be sending in here? Opponent sends in the Sableye, and I decide to bait with the Drill Run. Drill Run into the Sableye will be shielded. I'm looking to overfarm with the Escav and go for the Mega Horn. Mega Horn will be lethal. Mega Horn secures the knockout onto the Sableye. In the back, it's a Alolan Sandslash, and it's gonna be a sweep. Escavalier 1v3s in the end game, and that is a good game. All in all, I think that Escavalier is an extremely underrated anti-meta pick in the current Open Great League Blind 3s format. Escavalier just does very well into a lot of the things that people are bringing. Of course, some weaknesses, it really doesn't like Medicham, and it really doesn't like Gligar, so in a backline, I wanted Pokemon that both have neutral to positive matchups against those Pokemon, but outside of that, I found that it honestly did very, very well. It can fight back against a lot of common things that we're seeing in the meta, and especially considering how strong certain things are right now, like Superior just being absolutely absurdly powerful, it's really nice to have a Pokemon on your team that can just completely shut down those grass types. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. If you're enjoying the content, make sure to leave a like and subscribe to the channel if you haven't. And a special thank you, as always, to our members here on YouTube. The support guys provide is sincerely appreciated. Thank you guys oh so very much. And until next time, I've been Home Slice Henry.